everyone. So for today's video, my cat is going to be screaming, most likely. I locked him out of my office because he's being very clingy, annoying, and spoiled. So if you hear any yowling noises in the background, it's him. Anyways, sorry for the weird intro. Today's video is a very exciting video. I'm so excited to get started. Basically, it's a collaboration with Static Wool, who's an artist here on YouTube and on Instagram. I'm a huge fan of her art. I actually found her YouTube channel while looking for like sketchbook tours, as one does, and I fell in love with her art style. It's amazing. You should go check it out. So we've actually been talking about collaborating for quite a while now, but you know, like, stuff just kept coming up. Anyways, finally, I can do it. I have time, no other commitments, and I'm really excited for it. So the theme for today's collaboration is that we basically picked prompts together. Two prompts from me and two prompts from her, and then we each draw all four prompts in a sketchbook page or spread. So today I'm gonna be working on, where is it? I think this spread here, yeah. Are these two pages glued together? No. Okay, because I had a Mod Pod incident that just like glued my entire sketchbook shut. It was actually crazy. Anyways, yeah, this is the spread that I'm going to be working on today. I'm really excited. So for the prompts, my first one was flower slash plant with a human face, which I'm pretty excited for. And then my second prompt was just going to be motorcyclist. But I also had a third idea, which was all things chicken related. And we were kind of torn between the two, so I decided to just like combine them together. So my second prompt is actually chicken theme motorcycle, which is kind of weird, but I think it's gonna be fun. So yeah. Now Static will pick two prompts as well. Her prompts were sweet and sour and modern day mythical creature, which I'm super excited for. So Static Wool is also going to be doing these four prompts on her channel. So if you'd like to see her interpretation of the four prompts, go check out her video. I'll have it in the iCard above, and I'll also have it at the end of this video, in the description, everywhere. Now, the first thing I'm going to do is look for a bunch of reference photos on Pinterest. The Pinterest board that I end up using for this video will be posted in the description box in case you guys want to use the same photos. Also, if you guys would like to use the prompts, like, please feel free and tag me if you post them on Instagram or YouTube. I'd love to see them. Anyways, I'm gonna look for reference photos, make a Pinterest board, and then I'll start sketching. Okay, so this is when I start the sketching process for this video. And the prompt that I started with was the flower slash plant with a human face. I actually did some research for this prompt, and I wanted to find like flowers that match the expression face that I was gonna make. So this is a viola flower. I think it's pronounced like violet, but with an A at the end, like viola. Anyways, I'm not sure. But this flower has a sad meaning. I could not remember what the meaning is. I learned the meanings past tense, but I did not remember them. All I remember is that it had something to do with grief. So I made this like blank staring face. I don't know, it looks like very calm sad. Also, last video I complained about my portraits, like I was having a lot of trouble with proportions. So in this video I paid like very special attention, like I tried really hard to get the proportions right and to actually like the sketch. So yeah, I'm actually really happy. I feel like the extra effort paid off. Anyways, over here on the side I'm drawing these like natural tiny strawberries to symbolize sweet, and then for sour I drew a lemon. Now I felt like this was a little too literal. I had trouble figuring out what I wanted to do for this prompt, so I started off with just like, you know, strawberry, lemon, sweet and sour, but then I wanted to do something more creative, like something that took the prompt to the next level. So I ended up in a couple seconds drawing a Sour Patch Kid. I tried doing it on that side and then I did it on this side over here. But yeah, here's a cute little Sour Patch Kid. I love Sour Patch Kids. They're probably my favorite Maynard type candy. Yeah, they're amazing. I struggled so much with the Sour Patch Kid's face though. It was so funny, honestly. And I had this reference photo on Pinterest of like not a real Sour Patch Kid, but I think like the animated cartoon that's on the packaging. Anyways, here is a really rough sketch of the second flower face. I wanted to do a second one up here in the corner because I didn't know what else to do up there. I did a forget-me-not flower because I like the name, I like the color, the shape is super basic, which was great, even though I struggled with it, as you can see here. Now, unfortunately, the face that I made for this flower is not my favorite. I don't hate it, but I also don't really like how it turned out. Actually, no, don't like is too strong of a word. I just don't love it, but I like it. I really, really like how it turned out, but I don't really, really love how it turned out. Sorry, I just had to like distinguish that point. Anyways, so we have the two flower with human faces. We have the sweet and sour prompts. The whole slogan for Sour Patch Kids, I forgot to mention, is I think sour then sweet. I'm not sure. I'll have to search that up. Anyways, there's a little gap there, so I filled it up with some more words, you know, like collab with Static Wool. I wanted to remember this page, even though I'm pretty sure even without those words, I would have remembered, but it just looked cute there. Anyways, on to the next page. Over there, I sketched like a really vague human shape, and I had a vision for a chicken-themed motorcycle. Ever since we came up with the prompt and decided that we wanted to combine motorcycle and chicken, I had this idea of a chicken egg delivery guy who's like forced to wear this really ugly mascot. So that's what I did here. The helmet had the little top part that chickens have. I don't know what it's called. And then he's wearing this really creepy onesie. It's like fluffy, feathery, and the hood is supposed to be like the head of the chicken, which is really creepy, honestly. Anyways, unfortunately, I lost some footage, but he's also holding a carton of eggs and he has these creepy chicken feet boots on. Yeah, I had a lot of fun sketching him out, and I definitely want to sketch him out again, maybe change his uniform a bit, experiment with it. There's definitely room for experimentation with his uniform, to be honest. But more importantly, I started drawing the actual motorcycle here. Now, at the start, I did not draw this motorcycle with any changes whatsoever. I just used this one reference photo of like a vintage motorcycle. I'm not the best at drawing vehicles in general, so this was a really fun challenge and a nice change of like topic for me. Anyways, after I did like the base sketch for the motorcycle and it was looking good, I attempted to put a person on it, and then I was like, there's no way I'm putting a person on it. And then I just tried to make it more chicken-like. So I added eyes, and then the thing over the wheel is the beak, which is really creepy. And I added a wing and a little top part of the chicken. Yeah, I don't know. It's not as creative as it could have been, but I think it's cute, you know? It's definitely chicken themed. Anyways, down here, I'm doing the last prompt, which is a mythical creature, a modern day mythical creature. So I chose to do a centaur, and I chose to do an army centaur because you know how centaurs usually have bows and like they go to war and they fight and whatever. So yeah, that was the vision here. Fighting army centaur, but modern day. So he has like a gun. I don't know what type of gun that is, but it's a gun. And yeah, he's wearing like a modern military helmet, vest. He has some like gear in the back. Now, I did not invent the modern centaur idea. Unfortunately, someone else, or probably several people, have already thought of this idea. Like, I was on Pinterest, I was just looking for centaur reference photos, and I saw someone drawing like a military centaur, modern version. So yeah, it's not exactly my idea, but I thought of it. I just not the only one who thought of it. Anyways, here is the start of the coloring process. One of the reasons I was really, really excited for this video is because finally it was like, it wasn't collaboration with a company. It was a collaboration with another artist, but also like I was able to have the freedom to choose whatever art supply I wanted. Like I could finally color with whatever I wanted in whatever style I wanted. And I don't want to sound ungrateful or anything. I'm really, really grateful for all the collaborations with companies that I've been able to have. But I feel like I really need to take a break from it and just like focus on having fun with the supplies I already have. So for the next like probably a couple months, I don't think I'm going to be doing any collaboration with like an art supply company, unless if it's a crazy company, like something really cool, or unless if it's a paid sponsorship. So yeah, I just feel like it's so high energy and effort to do collaborations. And I just want to have fun using whatever I feel like in the moment. So for this video, for example, I felt like doing a realistic colored pencil artwork for the first time in ages. I haven't used colored pencils like this in such a crazy long time. I actually don't know when's the last time I did something like this. There was so much like detail involved, you know, the veins of the flower, the shadow placement and everything, and it was so fun. It brought back so much like fun memories from when I was like a teenager. I was one of those Prismacolor realism girlies when I was a teenager. Like I would hyper focus just on that, and it was really fun. It was a great time. Anyways, I'm glad I was able to go back to that and just like really focus and take my time. That's another thing I really appreciated. Honestly, a huge thank you to Static Wool. She was so patient with me because I kept having like delays when it came to this video. And honestly, she was so understanding. She told me not to rush and to just like enjoy the process, which was great. Like I actually did for the first time in a really long time. I didn't rush myself too much. Of course, I rushed myself a little bit because I was getting like so behind. But it was like a fun rush, not a hectic, I don't want to be doing this kind of rush. Anyways, yeah, I kind of went off topic. Well, not off topic, but like on a tangent there for a bit. But here's basically my process for doing the petals. I started off with like a baby blue color. Then I went on top with like magenta, white, like other colors to lighten it up and make it a light purple color, like a light violet. It's leaning more on the blue side than purple for some of the petals, like these three petals here. Anyways, after that, I just deepened the values with some dark, I think like ultramarine type blue. I'm not sure though. And yeah, I made sure some of the magenta still shine through because yeah, it looked really cool that way. Also in the reference photo, it wasn't just one big flat color. It was like a weird gradient. And so I made sure not to just like try and copy the reference photo exactly. I tried to make my own natural veins and shapes and stuff like that. So it looked more real. They kind of look like butterfly wings. Like they're so veiny compared to the reference photo, but I really love how it turned out. And the color scheme is so cool. Anyways, I'm just adding a little bit to this petal here so that it overlaps the final petal. And yeah, now I started doing the last petal. I had a different process for each petal. Like this one, I started with the veins and in dark blue, and then I went in with magenta. But yeah, it was pretty much very similar for each one. But yeah. Anyways, this was such a fun process. I really love drawing flowers, but only with colored pencils. Drawing flowers with paints stresses me out so bad. And I think it's because color pencil, I have more direct control. Like the pencil's in my hand, it has a very fine point, and I know exactly what the color will look like and like where I'm placing it. So yeah, flowers with colored pencils, super fun, highly recommend. But yeah, here is just like the final touches, the final little veins. And I think I'm pretty much done at this point with the flower. I'm just adding extra details. Anyways, I'm super happy with this thing here, this flower face. You're gonna see later on, I'm gonna color the actual face sitting there, but right now I'm just doodling random stars. I have to erase the pencil first because the Prismacolor pencils don't lay on top of pencil very well, which is a shame. Also, I drew like block letters for the type of flower because I thought it would fill up the corner there cutely. Yeah, it's such a headache though, writing with Prismacolor pencils because they're so soft, they kind of just like melt all over the place. Anyways, here I'm picking out a color theme for the face. I erased it with a kneaded eraser, but there's that little smudge on the nose. I had to end up being creative there with the shadow. Now, I went and started off by doing the shadows with the magenta color very, very softly. I just focused on all the darkest values in the reference photo. And then I went with cream and this pink middle tone to kind of blend those together. And already it was looking pretty good for a face. It was looking accurate, but also like my own original face, I guess. It's definitely not hyper-realism, the face. It's more illustrative than realistic, but the proportions are really nice and I'm really happy with the stylization of it. I don't know if that's a word, I think it is. Anyways, last time I felt like my faces, like in my pastel video, I felt like the faces were too stylized and it was really, really bugging me. I got a lot of comments telling me that I was too hard on myself, but like, I don't know, I just really feel like I could have done better and that I was limited by the supplies, and that's a very like frustrating feeling. So I was like taking out all my pent up energy from that video in this face here, and I really, really love how it turned out. It's kind of creepy in a way. I love the creepiness of it though. So I'm actually thinking of turning this illustration here into a sticker. I'd have to take like a high quality photo of it and like edit it a tiny bit digitally to make sure it actually works. But yeah, let me know if you guys would be interested in a sticker of it. It is a bit weird and creepy, but I think it also looks cute and pretty in a way. I don't know, let me know what you think. Anyways, next up I took out these, what's it called? Like Neo color crayons. I thought I would do the stars with it, but the precision was so bad and it was hard to get like a grip. So I ended up just doing the stars with colored pencils. I kind of wish I left the stars empty. So on the rest of the page, I leave a lot of the stars empty and I like how it looks. Anyways, here I am starting the lemon, but not really. I just started the easy part, which is the background element there. And then I leave that to start working on the strawberry. So for the strawberry, I decided that I didn't want to do another realistic colored pencil thing. I wanted a little break and to use watercolors. I would have used markers, but the previous page had some stuff that I was happy with and didn't want to destroy. So I ended up just using watercolors. Now the red was so vibrant, I was pleasantly surprised with that. And yeah, I don't know. This illustration for the strawberries, in my opinion, it got a bit too muddy, but it is like, it is a vibe. It does look kind of cool, but in my opinion, I wish I left it like this, super green, super red, and vibrant. But unfortunately, it does get muddy later on. Now, I wanted to do both background elements, like yellow and orange, because I really love that color combination with purple. I do feel though that I could have picked a calmer color for the background. Like I could have picked a lavender purple background and that also would have looked pretty cool, but it's okay. I'm still pretty happy with this. And oh yeah, here I'm making a checkerboard pattern for the background of the strawberries because I thought it would look really cute and it's very soothing and therapeutic doing the pattern. So yeah, I did that. I also lined the little background for the lemon over there, and here I'm picking out colors for the strawberry to, you know, give more definition with colored pencils because that's usually what I do with watercolors. But yeah, here's it getting all muddy. I added too many different colors, and also it's been a while since I've used Prismacolor pencils, so I forgot which green looked like what. And yeah, I don't know. I just prefer it before I did this, to be honest. For the strawberries though, I do like how they turned out, like the little fruits. They do look a bit like raspberries, but me and you, we know they're strawberries. So that's all that matters. Also, raspberries can be sweet too, so it works. And they're sour as well, so that's nice. Anyways, there's the sweet and sour. I made it my favorite shade of vomit green, basically. And then I continued filling in the background with the crayons for that lemon there. I used the crayon and then I used Prismacolor pencil on top to like do that. Now for the lemon, I do not like how it turned out. And that's the first time I'm saying this in this video. It looked good in this stage with just the watercolor, but later on I just make it too dark that it doesn't look like a lemon. It looks like some kind of orange lemon, which is okay. Like, I don't hate it. Again, I don't hate anything. it just got a bit too dark, which is totally fine. It happens all the time. Now, here is the start of the coloring process for the Sour Patch Kid. I had so much fun coloring this Sour Patch Kid. I tried to make it as realistic as possible, but also I didn't want to stress. I wanted to have fun with this process. So it's realistic, but it's not very realistic. It could be way more realistic than this. Also, I had trouble blending the dark red with the light red. So yeah, that was a bit of a challenge, but it's okay. I still really love how this turned out. Also, it was just such a weird thing to draw now that I'm thinking about it. Like, it was so random. And like, I don't know, it was fun. I've seen a lot of people do candy and gummies with hyper-realistic style with colored pencils. Not that this is hyper-realistic at all, but it was an attempt at hyper-realism. I think I need to go softer next time when layering the darks and lights, and maybe have some more medium tones so that it looks less textured. Also, I did this like little line border here, very simple, and added some red filled in stars, which I thought looked super cute. Also, the thing is, the Sour Patch Kid is filled with like sugar on top. And I was thinking of going with a toothbrush and like spraying white paint all over it, but I didn't want to damage anything else, so I ended up not doing that. But I do add highlights at the very end. Anyways, here I am coloring the forget-me-not flower. I thought I wasn't going to color it and just leave it as a pencil sketch, but I decided that the page needed more blue and I wanted to add it up here in the flower. I'm starting to like the blue-purple color combination. I used to think it was boring, but it's growing on me, that's for sure. So the forget-me-not flower was actually a lot more simpler than the viola flower. Sorry if I'm butchering the pronunciation. But yeah, a lot less vines. I actually added too much vines. I got carried away with details. And a lot simpler shadows as well. So that was nice. It was actually very quick to color, surprisingly. Anyways, this video made me realize or remember my love for colored pencils and why I enjoyed them so much. Like, this was so quick to color. With paints, I would have to wait for layers to dry, and it would most likely get muddy just because I'm not really good at paints, to be honest. I'm not really patient with paints. Colored pencils require like a different kind of patience, not a waiting kind of patience, just like break your wrist kind of patience, if that makes sense. Anyways, I started like doing that little red squiggle there. I kind of wish I didn't do it red. I wish I waited and decided on like the color for the text and then matched it, but it's all right. I erased the face there and then I started coloring. Now I thought I could do the same thing and make the shadows blue instead of purple, but I really, really wish I made them purple because, or yellow orange or something, I don't know. I wish I didn't put blue because the blue and the red and yellow turned into a really muddy brown color for the shadow. The yellow came from the cream skin tone. So yeah, I don't know. It didn't really work out the way I envisioned, but it still looks pretty cute. I think I just stared at it too long and I'm being too hard on myself again, as per usual. But yeah, also one of the eyes was like too big compared to the second eye. But I think I tried to salvage it at the very, very end of this video by making like the eye closer to us a little bit more closed. And it worked, like it helped a little bit. But yeah, next time I'll pay more attention to the proportions for the eyes. With the first face flower thingy, I did pay attention and like it looks pretty proportionate, like kind of proportionate. Anyways, here's when I started destroying the lemon. I don't know, I just don't like how it turned out, but it's definitely not, it's not ugly or anything crazy like that. It's just a bit too dark and defined. The watercolor version of the lemon was actually pretty cute in hindsight, but it's okay. I still like it. It's cool. Anyways, I make the text there yellow, which is why I wish I made the squiggle yellow as well. But yeah, I feel like I'm criticizing too much. I'm just like blurting all my thoughts out loud while watching this video play. I promise it's not being negative. I'm just like thinking while watching this. Yeah, on a sticky note there, I made the prompt list. I just wanted to like put something there to fill up the space, and I thought putting the prompt list was like fitting. Anyways, here I started like lining some of the elements on this page, like the text and stuff, which was really tedious because you have to like erase all the pencil lines first. And then I used this Tombow dual brush pen to put in all the green quickly. Now here I was hesitating whether I wanted to color the motorcycle or not. I wanted to draw the eggs in a more defined way, obviously, first. But then I decided not to color the motorcycle or anything on this page except for the background elements. And the reason is it was so busy already. And I wanted the first page to shine, to be honest. I knew that coloring this page would end up being like too messy, so I just colored like little things here and there, like the beak and the top part of the chicken bicycle. I thought it would look funny, and also just like background elements to make it pop, also stars. And yeah, here I'm just painting the background to make it easier, because coloring it with colored pencils would be torture without like a base layer. But yeah, I basically just colored the backgrounds and stuff like that and went over all the pencil lines to make it more defined. I even erased some parts for the centaur especially and tried to draw them more clearly now that I knew I wasn't gonna color it. I do kind of want to experiment with these characters like another time later on in my sketchbook and draw them in more detail. So like the chicken dude and the centaur guy. Yeah, I definitely think I could draw them in more detail, but I had limited space and I didn't want to flip to a new sketchbook spread. I wanted to stick to this spread, so I did have to draw them pretty tiny. Anyways, I'm still happy with how the layout turned out and how the sketches look. I think it's cute and it balances out all the crazy colors in the previous page. Here I'm just adding texture to the background behind the motorcycle. It just felt a bit too plain. So after all this, I go in with a white Posca marker at the very, very end and just add highlights to everything on the first page specifically. And then I was done. But yeah, overall, this was such a fun experience. I had such a blast with these pages. And yeah, I'm excited to see what Static Will has come up with. All right, so I think I'm pretty much done for today's video. Actually really happy with how this sketchbook spread turned out. I think this is like my favorite thing I've drawn in like a really, really long time. This one here specifically. And I really like how the Sour Patch Kid looks as well. So yeah, a huge thank you to Static Wool for collaborating with me. This was so much fun. Like, I forget the last time I had this much fun in my sketchbook. Also, I am whispering because it's like 4:28 a.m. and I'm filming an outro. I'm pulling an all-nighter. Yeah, fueled by Monster. Not sponsored, but definitely fueled by them. Anyways, I'm rambling. So I left these three here as just like pencil sketches with like little color, I guess, background elements. And the reason is, like, I really like the pencil sketches, that's first of all. But second of all, my wrist is in so much pain. This page took so much effort. Colored pencils are high maintenance, honestly. Like, they take a lot of, like, wrist work. So, yeah, my wrist is throbbing, but in a good way. Like, I'm actually really, like, happy I did that to myself. But also, like, a third reason I didn't color this with, like, watercolors or anything is because this page is already so colorful that I feel like the sketches here just give it a break, kind of. And they look kind of cute. So, yeah. Anyways, thanks again to Zetequil for collaborating with me. I actually can't wait to see what she makes with these prompts. Like, I'm so excited. I have no idea what she created with them. But yeah, if you guys would like to see her video doing these same prompts here, I know I want to see her video. I'm so hyped to see it. But yeah, if you guys would like to see it, I'll have it at the end of this video and also in the iCard here and also in the description box. Please go like watch it and support her. She's such an amazing, talented artist. I love her art so much. But yeah, I think I'm done rambling for this outro. I hope you guys enjoyed watching this video. And I'll see you guys in the next video, probably a lot later than expected. So I'm guesstimating 2 weeks, 3 weeks maybe. September is gonna be really busy, but I don't wanna ramble about that just yet. But yeah, I'll see you guys later on in September. Bye. Thank you.